Today we're going to build a shopping only performance max campaign on a live Google Ads account. Hi, I'm Andrey with AD Marketing, where I help e-commerce businesses run Google Ads. Because this account is of my current client, all sensitive information will be blurred out, but all technical steps and results will be clearly visible. Let's go. The client is a retailer of home decor, bath and body, and home fragrance brands. They've been online for over 25 years and have been running Google Ads for over 20 years. Their main competitors are Wayfair and Amazon, because those brands appear there as well. The account runs mostly shopping ads for each brand. We will switch one of the shopping campaigns with a Performance Max campaign, with the eventual goal of growing revenue. The shopping campaign contains 90 SKUs for a popular home fragrance brand. It spends approximately $1,600 per month and brings on average 66 conversions with a ROAS of 3.1. Now let's set up a Performance Max campaign. Inside the Google Ads All Campaigns view, click on the blue plus sign and select New Campaign. As the objective, select Create a Campaign Without Goals Guidance. As a campaign type, select Performance Max. Let's name the campaign. For bidding, leave conversion value with target unchecked. Click Next. For the locations, select the United States. Later we'll come back and make one important change. Expand automatically created assets and deselect text assets and final URL. We want to keep everything tight at least for now. Click Next. Now we will create the first asset group. It has to be with assets, but the next group we can create without assets. After that, we'll remove the first group. We enter the required assets and click Next. On the budget page, we select Set Custom Budget and set it to $80. This is higher than the historical average of 66 per day, but we give some more breathing room to the campaign to let it generate conversions quicker and this way shorten the learning period. Click on Publish the campaign. Now, with one full asset group in the campaign, we are able to create another group without assets and then remove the first asset group. Let's do that. Click on Asset Groups in the campaign view, click on blue plus sign, name the asset group Feed Only, click on All Products, use a selection of products, select the appropriate product brand. Click Save. We are back at the asset group view. Click on the Enable status of the first asset group and select Remove. Next, we will add audience signals. Audience signals allow you to add audience suggestions that help Google Ads AI optimize your selected goals. I always add audience signals to the new campaign because they help shorten the learning period. Click on Audience Signals. I have already built an audience signal. I will add it and explain how I created it. This audience signal has three sections: custom segments, your data, and interest and detailed demographics. My custom segment contains two parts: people who search for any of these terms on Google. I usually add 3 to 5 most popular search terms. Search terms can be loosely compared to the broad match keywords in the search campaigns. In our case, search terms help the campaign to place shopping ads in front of the right people. People who browse websites similar to. Here I usually add competitors' URLs. Your data. Here I usually add website visitors, email subscribers, or even better, purchasers' audiences. Interests and detailed demographics. I typically add the closest in-market audiences. Often pretty detailed audiences can be found, like in our case, home fragrance products, room spray, and fragrances for the home. One last thing. In settings location, set target to presence. We want to show ads to the people who are physically present in our location. And we are ready to go.
We've replaced a shopping campaign with a shopping only Performance Max campaign. I'll be monitoring it and keep you posted on the progress. I'm Andrey with AD Marketing. If you found this content valuable, hit like, subscribe, and click on the bell icon to get notified on new episodes. Thank you and have a great day.